Bill Plack here. Whoops, John Berglund, right?
Bergeron.
And you are in Kona for, what? Is this your first race in Kona?
This is my second race in Kona.
Okay. That's right. You may have talked about that earlier. Yeah. So what's changed between 2015 and 2019?
Well, a whole lot has changed. 2015, I actually had my grandson, who was only 2 months old here. I was just born. Everything was awesome. Got together with a family reunion. Had brought my family over, my son and his family from Japan. Had a, you know, okay race. You know, I had some bruised ribs going into it, so it wasn't my best. So got home, everything was fine. Had a great vacation. And a few months later, all of a sudden, my grandson is getting on a flight for life to Denver Rocky Mountain Children's Hospital, and I got diagnosed with leukemia. And from there, everything went downhill. They only gave him a 20% chance of survival. They put him in a medically induced coma for a while, slow everything down, and that little guy just kept on fighting. Yeah. And came up with the name Mighty Max. You know, his name is Maxwell, so he became Mighty Max. So he was in the hospital for 6 months straight. I mean, my daughter lived there. I would spend the weekends there if I could. And he had two full years of chemotherapy to beat that thing. And he's finally in remission. And the whole time, I just felt like, you know, there wasn't anything I could do. You know, it was like kind of useless. I'm used to taking care of things. You know, I spent 26 years in the Army getting things done. This past year, I qualified for both Boston Marathon and Kona in the same year. So I thought, hey, not a whole lot of people have done that. Let me try and use that, you know, to an advantage to try and help out and raise some money for pediatric cancer research. Pediatric cancer research, unfortunately, only gets about 4% of all the funding towards cancer research, you know, especially from the government. So I'm like, hey, let's try and do some more. Maybe I can do something. So I got all these, you know, Instagrams and Facebooks and this and that. Came up with the logo, Boston to Kona for Mighty Max, and been doing a fundraiser ever since. So that's my main purpose of being here, is to get the awareness out there, get the notoriety, you know, for pediatric cancer research, which, like I say, I don't understand why they don't put more at the beginning when kids are just starting life. Instead of, you know, so much later. Not to say that any of these other causes are any worse, it's just, you know.
So what is Mighty Max here in Kona?
No, he wasn't able to make it this year. And like I say, he is in remission, but right now he's like any other four-year-old. He's 4 years old now. And but they only give him a 20% chance of reaching adulthood. Because the type that he has, unfortunately, is a bad kind, and it almost always comes back with a vengeance. So we hope and pray that he's in that 20%, and maybe some of the funds that I can raise can make that magic breakthrough, you know, so the next time if he has to go into you know, chemo again, they come up with the right protocols, you know, because right now it's a crapshoot.
So how would you rate that as a motivator on a day where it's a You're not feeling it. You got to get out and train. You got to get on a long ride. What keeps you? What's that carrot?
Well, believe it or not, there's been plenty of those days because I still work full time and training twice a week. You know, twice a day, 6 days a week gets tough. But when those tough days come along, I think of how bad it was for Max. You know, he just fought through it, and I feel almost like the better I can do, then the better people be motivated for Max, you know, and for kids' cancer research. Maybe motivate them a little bit more to, you know, donate a little bit more. You know, so I am here to leave it all out in the course, and there won't be anything left, believe me.
So last time you were here, you did Ironman Boulder, which was in August. Tough turnaround. You were beat up.
10 weeks.
Yeah, and this year you qualified in Chattanooga?
Chattanooga, yeah.
A year ago, essentially.
Yeah.
So how do you feel this year compared to 15?
Well, compared to 15, I am definitely much better shape. I had more than 10 weeks to prepare and recover. I don't have the bruised ribs this year. My training's been going great. Everything's been going good, so I'm just keeping the fingers crossed, and I think I'm going to have a much better race this year than 2015.
So thinking about the course in 2015, you break the course down into different parts, obviously swim, bike, run, but even further than that, amongst the bike, you have the downhill Javi or the uphill the Javi or the energy lab on the run. What are you going to maybe do different than you did in 2015?
I'm going to try and keep my head down a lot more on that bike. Those headwinds beat me up last time. They really did. The headwinds really beat me up coming back from Javi. It seemed like I was 40 miles into headwinds, and I've gotten a little bit better on staying down in the aero, which definitely helps with that. And hopefully I can go faster downhill, faster than 10 miles per hour this year, pedaling in the wind.
Okay, well, so let's wrap up, and let's say something for Max and tell people how they can get involved and donate to your cause.
Okay, Max, this is all for you, little bud. Okay, he's going to be watching me online at home. And for anybody interested, it's real easy, Boston to Kona for Mighty Max, using the number 2 and the number 4 on Instagram and Facebook, and those will point you to the fun site, which is also a Boston to Kona from Mighty Max on CrowdRise.
Great. Thanks a lot. Good luck.
Thank you very much.
All right.